Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will demonstrate how to customize rows and columns in a Vue Pivot Table. I will show you how to customize the height of a row, width of a column, and grid lines. You will also see how to change the display of the cell content using text wrap and clip mode properties. First, I will open an existing Vue application that has a pivot table with a list of data retrieved from a local data source. If you want to know how to get started with the Vue Pivot Table component, refer to the video linked in the card above. I will run this application using the npm run dev command and show the initial demo. You can see the pivot table rendered with the defined data source. By default, the row height of a pivot table is 36 pixels and the column width is 110 pixels. If you want to customize the height and width based on the cell content, use the row height and column width properties. To demonstrate, I define the grid settings property inside the data function and set the row height to 60 pixels and column width to 200 pixels. Now, I need to assign this grid settings to the component using the grid settings property. The pivot table now renders with the custom row height and column width. You can also resize the width of a column in the UI by dragging its right edge. Notice here, when I resize the column to a smaller width, the content of the cell exceeds the boundary and truncates the text. This is the default clip mode behavior. The Syncfusion Vue pivot table also supports two other clip modes, ellipsis and ellipsis with tooltip. Let me demonstrate the ellipsis with tooltip mode. In the grid settings, I set the clip mode property to ellipsis with tooltip. When I resize the column and the cell content overflows, see the ellipsis is displayed with a tooltip. If you want to display the cell content in a new line instead of showing the ellipsis, use the AllowTextWrap property. To demonstrate, I define the AllowTextWrap property and set its value to true. Looking here, when I resize the column, the text wraps up and is displayed in the next line. By default, the content in the pivot table's row, column, and value headers is left aligned while the value cells are right aligned. In addition to these positions, the pivot table also supports center and justify. In this example, I will show you how to align the row header content to the right. Before that, I will remove the row height and column width properties, because I want to display them in their default values for my application. To set the right alignment for the row headers, I define the columns render function, which receives the args argument. Within the function, I will check if the row headers are not null and set the text align to right. Now, the row headers in the pivot table are right aligned. Similarly, you can align the content of column headers, value headers, and value cells using the columns render function. Next, let's see how to select a record. Before that, we'll remove the column render function definition, as I want to display the row headers aligned to the left. To select a record, I set the allow selection property to true. Look, I can select a row by clicking on a record. Along with this default row selection, the Syncfusion Vue pivot table supports three more selection modes: column, cell, and both. Now, I will show you how to select a cell. I define the selection settings property and set the mode to cell. As you can see, I am able to select a cell. Notice here, you can select only one cell at a time because the default selection type is single. If you want to select more than one record at a time, you can use the type property and set it to multiple. Now, you will be able to select multiple cells at a time using the Control key. Finally, I will show you how to customize gridlines. By default, the pivot table displays both horizontal and vertical gridlines. Apart from this default option, you can also display horizontal, vertical, and none. To display only vertical gridlines, I set the gridlines property to vertical. See, the pivot table is rendered only with vertical gridlines. In this video, you have seen how to customize the height of a row, width of a column, and gridlines on the pivot table. If you would like to see the working example, download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Vue products through our community license. If you found this video useful, do like the video and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.